Welcome. So let's begin with the 2nd December analysis for your geography paper NTA examination. Now this time the paper was surprisingly different as you had two questions that were based on reading comprehension. This was the first time that reading comprehension was part of your question paper for your geography examination. You had reading comprehension questions coming in for, let's say, psychology examinations and other optionals that were there. But for geography, it was introduced for the first time. And therefore, now you have a new trend setter on what kind of questions would be coming. And definitely students had a lot of questions regarding that. The syllabus was something different, the questions came up something different, but it's not like that. The questions were exactly from the syllabus. The only thing is, whatever is there in the syllabus, you have to cover it, not just the new topics that I have introduced, so that you don't need to cover the old topic. So be very, very careful that these are the things that you have to cover. And for the comprehension section, the questions were one from the physical geography, that was the tropical cyclone that was covered. The second question was from the industrial geography, which talked about the Smith's theory. So you had two questions based on reading comprehension and five questions were there on both of these passages. So passage based question gaining importance now. Remember, the reading comprehension questions that comes up for your paper 1 and for your geography optional or any subject optional are very different. For your paper 1, most of the information you have to know based on the passage that is given. Okay, because you are totally blind to what the passage is. But here it is expected, it is basically assumed that you already know that topic. So it's not always necessary that the questions are directly answered from the passage. Passage would give you an outline about what the tropical cyclone is, might be the kind of climate changes taking place and the scenario changing because of which you have higher number of cyclones being witnessed. So there could be something recent might be related to that thing, and then you could have questions based on the general questions of tropical cyclone. So that's how you have the differences on those. Now coming on to the basic questions, the rote memory questions, I would say. The questions were based on who gave the circumference of the earth. The question was based on who gave the term geopolitics. So those were kind of very, very basic and direct questions that were there. But besides these, what kind of questions you need to keep in mind? Questions pertaining to geosyncline, erosional and depositional landforms. Now all of those we have covered through our video lectures, and more importantly there was one question on hypsographic curve. Now hypsographic curve is very, very important. We have covered that elaborately in our new edition, so the new topics, the sections that have been added for new topics cover that very, very elaborately, and these are the topics which have been gaining importance of recent. Coming on to the section on human geography, you had questions related to quantitative revolution. Coming on to physical geography, as I already said, you had geosyncline, erosional and depositional landforms that were asked. Besides that, you also had questions on, let's say, the Ria Coast. A lot of questions were based on the concepts of social and cultural geography this time. So gaining importance are the sections pertaining to human geography. You had questions from health policy. Also, there were questions based on the organic theory of state, match list question that were very, very popular. The index questions under transport geography. So the alpha, beta, gamma index becomes very, very important under transport geography. So those kind of questions, the node, the edge, the vertex. So those we have covered when we have covered the classes on the transport geography. So below you would have the links to some of the most important topics that are useful for your examination perspective. And as I said, it's not just the conventional questions that are asked as of now. Now you have lot of contemporary questions being added to the syllabus. So let's say what we cover through the Down to Earth edition. So Down to Earth is a magazine that comes every fortnightly, every 15 days for environmental issues. You had questions that were pertaining to kind of concepts coming in those magazines. So it's very, very important, not just the conventional sections are to be covered, but also you have to keep yourself updated with the contemporary information. And that's one of the main things that has come across across this paper. A lot of agitation has been seen among the students regarding the questions were not exactly what they thought about, or they were not based on syllabus, but it was nothing like that. All these topics that we are discussing here are part of your syllabus directly or indirectly. So there was nothing out of the syllabus. Make very, very sure, clear concepts about this. Everything is confined within the syllabus. The only thing is you have to go into the depth of the syllabus. So definitely through our videos, we have covered a lot of topics. Below you would have the list to the video lectures, to the videos that are already covered, and you can refer those. And definitely if you have any other questions, any other doubts, feel free to contact me. Any of your mail that comes in at admin@examraise.com directed to my name would be forwarded to me for any further queries. Have a wonderful day ahead.